One of the new features we've added to trakax Pro is the ability to directly upload your video and photo slideshow mixes to YouTube. Firstly, I'll show you how to upload from the mixing screen. To do this, click on the target frame size drop-down menu and choose the resolution you want, be it YouTube HD, YouTube High Quality, or YouTube Low Res. Once selected, the Upload to YouTube button will be activated. These YouTube settings have been optimized to give the best quality output while maintaining a reasonable file size. Simply put, if you wish to upload your video as HD, simply select the YouTube HD button. If you do not already have a YouTube preset selected in the target frame size drop-down menu, the Upload to YouTube button will be deactivated. After you've selected your YouTube target frame size, either click on the Upload to YouTube button or right-click in the mixing window and select the YouTube button at the bottom of the drop-down menu. When you click on the YouTube button, the Render and Upload to YouTube box will appear. Here I can create a new YouTube user account if I do not already have one. If I click on the Create New Account button, I'll be taken to the Create New Account page within the application. If I already have an existing account, I can just enter my details in the username and password boxes. If I've forgotten either my username or password, I can retrieve them by clicking on the Forgot Username or Forgot Password buttons. Once I've entered my details, I must select a destination on my hard drive for the mix to be rendered to before I can upload. I can click on the Browse Folder button to select a location for my rendered file. The Render To File dialog box will appear and name the file as you wish, and then click Save. The upload quality indicates to me which YouTube quality setting and frame size I've selected. Just a word of note, the high definition option will take longer to render and upload, as the file size will be much larger than the high quality and low res quality. In the title box, I can give the video the title which will appear in YouTube. Here I'll name it Skater Mix. Beside the title box, I have the public button. It's currently defaulted to on, which means it's viewable to everyone on YouTube. If I click on it, a red cross will appear, telling me it's made private and will only be viewable by you and people you've invited. You can always change this by going into the video settings within YouTube and editing in it. In the description box, I can give a description of the video, post links, and any other information that I want to give. In the keywords box, you can give keywords which will help people searching that particular topic to find your video quickly and easily. In the category drop-down menu, I can select a category from the numerous categories provided by YouTube. Here I'll select sports, as I've created a sports video. One thing to note, if one of the fields is left blank, the upload button will be grayed out, indicating a field is empty and needs to be filled in order to upload. Once all my fields are full, I can now render and upload my video mix or photo slideshow to YouTube. I can also directly upload to YouTube through the media browser. Simply right-click on your file and select Upload to YouTube. This is completely independent of the target frame size, and the quality of the file uploaded will depend on how it was rendered in the first place.